too. And that wasn't it, whatever that is. Have any idea? Got a wire somewhere. I started to write the script for this presentation about 12 times, and finally I just gave up because there was so much to talk about this next group, and I didn't really need a script to do it because even though I wasn't at all the shows or all the performances of this next group, I know them quite well. And it's been my privilege to know them and have done shows with most of the folks that are here today. At some point or another, I've done shows with them. Excuse me, sorry. Apologize, someone left the door open and it was getting rather cold down here on these folks, I think. Anyway, I've done a lot of shows with them, and I found out that over the years just how unselfish their group is and how many people that they have helped over the years. For example, if you ask Fred Newell down in Nashville, or you ask Tommy Rutledge, who plays with Alan Jackson, or Kenny, who's here, Joe Fortune, some of the other folks, a lot of the musicians that are out there. And if you ask them, they can tell you with feelings from the heart about this next group. They can tell you how they were individually helped and what fun and great music that they have played together over the years. And if you ask Uncle Johnny Barton and the Corn Belt Country Style show and all the shows at the fair and on the radio and television, they can tell you, and Johnny can tell you, how important this next group was in pioneering country music here in the Midwest. So I really didn't need a script, and if you go and you look through the things that we have here, and we discuss Illini Records and the fact that all the folks that recorded over there, and I remember the first time when I was doing Country People magazine, and I went and did a story on Illini Records, and Kenny Bowers had just cut a record, and Shirley Barr had cut records, and of course Cousin Sipe. I've written a lot of articles over the years about Cousin Sipe. In fact, he was the Comedian of the Year in 1975 for Country People magazine that we had. And as I went on and trying to decide how much to tell you and what to tell you and what to remind you of, I ran across, of course, this particular album here. And a gentleman who was connected with Andy and Cousin Sipe and the group wrote the liner notes for this. And I think he said it better than I could come up with. So I decided the best thing to do would be to read an excerpt from the back of this album. In order to do this, I'm going to go over there where I can see. So just a second. And I know that some of you have heard this before, but I'd still like to read it. From the happy opening instrumental of a preacher, Andy's father was a preacher, and this has been the theme song of Andy and the group for many years, to the beautiful shut-in's prayer, a recitation that Andy does to perfection, you fully realize just why Andy Acree and the Country Squires are considered to be one of the finest country music groups in the Midwest. Their versatility combined with their outstanding talent has spotlighted to the fullest in this exciting first album. When I speak of versatility, I mean Leroy Clark, who not only sings a good country song, but he aptly writes them as well. Known in the Springfield area as the granddaddy of country music, and according to this, at this time, he wasn't really that old, but we won't say that today. Sorry. Andy Akrey has not only supplied the bass sounds and MC work for the group, but his leadership has made the difference between a good group and a superior one. However, it was not easy starting at age 14 when he sang on the telephone to his neighbors, joining his first band at 17, appearing whenever possible, keeping active, and always striving to improve his sound by having the finest musicians in his band. And if we list those musicians, as I mentioned before, Fred and Tommy and Kenny and Joe and all the rest of them, Jack Sampson's who flew in today, then you know what I'm talking about when I say the best in musicians. Television appearances with Uncle Johnny Barton, whom he credits for much of his success today and on Cornbelt Country Style and on Johnny's numerous fair dates, has added to his growing legion of fans. Along with Johnny, he owes a great deal to Glenn Hurley, who plays comedian Cousin Sipe on his shows, for all his assistance, encouragement, and knowledge. I am proud to be asked to write these few words, for I feel this album is a major credit to country music in the Midwest, utilizing all Midwestern musicians, producers, engineers, and sound studios. Andy has brought his fans a solid album of country sounds, Sounds of the Midwest. That was written by Marv Horner. Okay. There are some country squires who are not with us today. We'd like to pay a little tribute to them before we bring out the group. Charlie Brown from 1924 to 1968, Springfield, Illinois. Originally from Virginia, Illinois, was a former band member of Jesse Cox's Virginia Buckaroos, broadcasting over WLVS radio in Jacksonville, Illinois in the late 40s. Charlie joined Andy Akrey's Cumberland Mountain Boys in the late 50s and became the Country Gentleman in 1961. And that group became the Country Squires. Post office. The song he is singing here was cut in August 25th, 1967 at WCBS Radio in Springfield.
So you say you're happy now, you found a new love.
Folks in this room are very fortunate to have played music with Jack Welch and knew him very well. Let's give Jack a nice round of applause. Country squires. Along with Andy Akrey, Fred Newell, and Charlie Brown, Gene had joined Andy and the Cumberland Mountain Boys in the late 50s, and in the early of 63 wrote two songs, Breaking My Vow and Engineer Mountain, in which Uncle Johnny Barton of WHOW Radio in Clinton, Illinois, pitch to Tommy Hill, producer for Starday Records in Nashville. The record was released in January of 1964, and although the record was not a national hit, it did quite well regionally and earned the Squires a weekly radio show that lasted 9 years. Gene left the Squires after a couple of years to pursue other business interest, and later on took him back to Nashville, where he worked for Johnny Cash for over a year. Gene Kirk Pearson passed away in 1981. He was a fine singer and songwriter, country music, lost a good friend. Here he is singing Engineer Mel. And now at this time, it gives me great pleasure to formally induct into the Country Music Hall of Fame Andy Acree and the Country Squires. Please make a motion. Certificate reads, the Illinois Country Music Museum and Hall of Fame induction, for your dedication to Illinois country music and the many years of service you give to the music industry, the Illinois Country Music Museum and Hall of Fame honors you today with this membership into the Illinois Hall of Fame. Andy Acree and the Country Squires, October 26, 1997.
So many people to thank for all these wonderful years. I had a great big speech that I don't think I can say it. There's so many people out there that I really want to thank, and we give the article in the journal. We've talked to about so many people that's in the band, and a lot of them was left out. They wasn't mentioned. Like the lady here that was spent 13 years singing to the Squires. For some reason or another, she got left out. But let's recognize her right now. How about Miss Janie Elston? And of course, as Dennis mentioned, we've got some people out in the audience who've been very great friends, members of the Country Squires over the years. Joe Fortune and Ken Decker, would you take a bow? Give those guys a hand. They've been members of the Squires for a long time. Also, I'm very happy that Gene Pearson's widow and his daughter is here today, which I have not seen for probably 25 years. Would you please stand up, Lisa and Maxine, take a bow. Dennis, there's so many people to thank that there's no way that I can thank them all. I want you to know, and also Bob and Lorraine Rutledge is here, Tommy's mom and dad. We want to remember them. We had lots of times over the years. Still do have. And naturally, I have to thank my wonderful wife, Ruby. Honey, would you stand up? My daughter, my granddaughter, my daughter-in-law, they're all here today. My grandson. We just have so many people that showed up, and we're so proud of all of you. And I'm certainly proud of this bunch of guys here. My son has been with me for years. Gene Akeley on the drums. Of course, Jack Sampson, that came in from North Charleston, South Carolina, to be with us here today, to go to the Hall of Fame with us. Jack, so good to have you. Skip Woodard has been a member several different times of the Country Squires over the years, good friends. First started playing with us in 1973. Fine steel guitar player. I'm going to have steel for Skip Woodard. Kenny Bauer, that first started working on the road with the Country Squires, worked a lot of fair dates with us through the northern part of the state, Rockford and Wisconsin, all over, and been with us several different times over the years. He's back with us again. Mr. Kenny Bowers, ladies and gentlemen. A good friend of over 30 years that we have played music all over the country, in Nashville, all over Illinois, and I'm so glad that he's still with us today, and I'm glad you cut off that damn beard. My good friend, Don Dunham, ladies and gentlemen. Right now, you got anything else to say?
Just getting ready to introduce you whenever you're done. I knew you were going to introduce all these folks, so that's why I didn't mention all of them. And you wanted to thank everybody personally, and I appreciate that. But whenever you're ready. Is that a guitar chord over there, Don, that's doing that? Or? We weren't sure whether to induct them into the Hall of Fame before or after they played. So if Andy's ready, I think we can do this. He's trying to be ready. So let's give a great round of applause, if you would, to Andy Akeley and the Country Squires.
Member of our group is not here yet, isn't it?
He's always late.
Has anybody seen Sipe?
Hey! Get in here.
Oh, my Lord.
That's got a squirrel. Where have I been?
You're late.
Am I late?
Yes. I picked you up at the airport yesterday afternoon, took you and put you in a motel, and what happened to you after that?
I like to not sleep all night long.
Why?
I tell you what, I had a terrible night. I mean to tell you, it was bad. I never got no sleep, and I slept in, overslept.
Well, you must have, yeah.
Yeah.
You know, I could have come and got you.
And you know, I cried. And, but all night long, this woman kept knocking on my door. That's the way it was.
Right.
Is that you, boy? This woman kept beating on my door, kept beating on my door. I couldn't get no sleep.
Well, what did you do about it?
I finally got up and let her out.
I don't know what to tell you.
I know what to tell you. You know, I got to tell you folks something. I had the most terrible experience yesterday. You know, go ahead, honey. I'm staying at Holiday Room, it's Holiday Inn, room 707, and tomorrow night I'll autograph that for you. I tell you what, yesterday he picked me up at the airport. I flew in. I'll never do it again. I'll take an airplane the next time. I came in. Andy was there to pick me up at the airport, just like he said he would. He came and picked me up. He's got this brand new Buick automobile. Ooh, it's a big summer. I mean, it's from here to yonder long. So he picked me up, and he, I tell him, boy, this is sure a pretty car, Andy. And he said, oh, yeah. He said, let me show you everything it's got. Boy, you push this button, it does that, and you push this button, it does that, and the windows go up and down, and the mirrors go in and out. It just does about everything. He's telling me it's got, oh, golly, it's got this big sound system in it. And it's got those anti-lock brakes. Well, it's got them new kind of disc brakes on it. They call them anti-lock brakes. Okay. And he's telling me how good those boogers are. He says they'll stop you on a dime and just, well, no, he says it won't do a thing. I said, well, that sounds pretty good, Andy. As a matter of fact, that's really good. Well, we're going into town, so he wants to show me these new brakes. I said, oh, heck, Andy, that's okay. Well, I'm telling you, he started out and he got up that thing up to 40 mile an hour. We're going, I'm telling you. He got up to 50 mile an hour. I'm starting to get scared. He says, oh, I don't worry about her sight. He says, I got these new anti-lock brakes. He says, it'll just stop you like that. And he says, you see that piece of paper down yonder in the road? I looked, I said, yep. Watch this, he says. But now he's running 50 mile an hour. He gets up to that thing. He puts on these anti-lock brakes. I'm telling you, the old car stopped. And I looked out, and the old bumper's going up and down. He says, what do you think of that? So that's pretty good. That old piece of paper landed right underneath that bumper. It's just going up and down. I said, that's pretty good. He says, heck, that ain't nothing. I said, no, that's all right. You don't have to show me no more, Andy. That's fine. We're going down the road, and the first thing you know, we're running 70 mile an hour. I said, Andy, that's another stop. I said, my God, Andy, there's a train. Oh, there's a train. We're going to hit it. Oh, he says, no. He said, don't worry about it. He slammed on those there anti-lock brakes. Well, I got up out of the floorboard, and I looked out. Here is the train. That sucker is just about that far from our front bumper, and it's going by. Woo! He said, well, Sipe, he said, what do you think of that? I said, I think you better take me back that piece of paper, Andy.
Oh, Lord, I don't know what to do with him. Right now.
Wait a minute, we're going on down the street. We're going down the street, and he's a yakking. He don't pay no attention to where he's going, let alone where he's been. I told him, I said, Andy, better slow this thing down. You're going to hit somebody. He never paid no attention, and about that time, some old boy, he kind of just stepped off the edge of the curb, you know. Andy brushed him with his fender, knocked the poor old fella down. Old fella. Laying on the street there. He got up, he's brushed himself off, Andy put on them there new brakes, and he stopped that car, and he got out, and he says, "Hey, old man, you better watch what you're doing." He says, "Why? You turn around coming back?"
He's got all kinds of stories like that. Right now, we'd like to have Kenny Bowers come up and sing a real pretty song for you, one that we think he does to perfection. One that Jimmy Dickens had out many years ago called Pride. Did you say about his girlfriend?
I said it felt like she had a wart right there on her.
Jamie, honey, would you sing a song for us? This is the young lady that I told you earlier. I got mic trouble here. This lady worked in our band for 13 years. And the gentleman that discovered her had to leave a little bit ago. I was hoping he'd be here for this, but a good friend of ours from Springfield, Mr. Ansel Henson, found this girl singing at the Old Harness House Club on Wabash in Springfield, Illinois in 1967. And we was the house band at the Wishing Well Club on North Peoria Road. He called me on break and said, I've discovered a young lady that's really a good singer, and she's trying to work with kind of a pop band, but he said she really can sing country music. And he said, would you listen to her if I bring her out? And I said, sure. And we happened to be looking for a girl singer at the time. Ansel brought her out, and she sang a song called Don't Touch Me. Jeannie Seely just had that out, and it was high on the charts at the time. Jeannie sang it, and I hired her on the spot, and we took her into the studio the next day on Sunday at WCBS and started cutting a bunch of radio shows, and she stayed with us for 13 years. Here's Pretty Miss Jeannie Elston singing Don't Touch Me.
Be there.
Yes. I got to straighten something out with this little girl right here. She don't understand why she's talking about my socks. And I don't see nothing wrong with them. See my socks?
They're not the same.
I got another pair at home just like them. She also don't like, she says my pants are too short. Honey, I didn't know when I was 6 years old I was going to be 6 foot tall. I had these that long.
I'll tell you what, now you behave, because we're going to get Jack Sampson up to sing a real pretty song, okay?
Yeah.
Can you? No, I don't think so. Right now, if we can get Jack Sampson up to the microphone, we think he does this real pretty. We used to do this years ago when, right after Waylon Jennings come out, and I don't know why we never did record the thing. Mark Chesson come along and had a big hit on it, and we was singing a long time before Mark Chesson was, wasn't we? This is one called Sensuous Woman, featuring Jack Sampson. Janie, honey, come here a minute. He's bugging me till he wants me to introduce you. Get around here on the other side here, but don't get too close to her now. Behave yourself. Janie, this is Cousin Sipe. You do? Well, Sipe, This is Janie. Now, he keeps asking me something. He says, well, he's staying down here in the motel.
Well, I am going to be staying tonight, you know, and I thought maybe you never had nothing else to do, you know, you ain't got nothing to do. Well, I just kind of thought maybe that, oh heck, we might get together, watch some, oh boy, man. We might get together and watch some movies, you know, and watch you again. You got popcorn? Do you? Oh God, I got some with me, look at there. I brought some popcorn. We can pop popcorn and watch movies. Oh. Yeah, hey, popper ideas. We got a popper.
Do you guys think it's safe? Do you think it'd be all right?
Yeah.
I'd like to sing a song for him. Would that be okay? Would you guys mind? I really like him. I'd really like to go. What do you think? Do you think? Yes. Is that all right with you?
Nobody ever sang to me before.
Is that okay with you guys?
Yeah.
Are you sure? Satin sheets to lie on.
I know it's been a long afternoon, ladies and gentlemen. We've got time for probably one or two more. It's 5:15. We'd like to feature, we're going to have Don Dunham do a couple more songs for us. And I'd like to say Don has been with me for many, many years. We've been very close. We've been all over the country together. And between him and Kenny Bowers and Jack Sampson, I don't think that you'll find three better singers anywhere in this country. And right now we're going to feature him on one called A Way to Survive, Mr. Don Dunham.
I look at your picture too often, and it helps keep your memory alive. Baby.
we kindly looked over when I didn't tell Dennis about this, but he mentioned three former members of the Country Squires has passed on. There was actually six, but one of them was the gentleman you heard playing the lead guitar on Charlie Brown's Window Shopping, and that was Joe Wolford. That was with us back in those years in the 1960s. Him and Kenny Decker and Russ Schroeder was drumming for us at that time. He later went on to drum for Kitty Wells and David Houston down in Nashville. And Joe passed away, and Kenny and I have been trying to think. We think about 19 and, what was it, 91? Something like that, that he passed away. And also another gentleman that used to pick with us years ago, Bobby Bradham, has went on. And we certainly don't want to forget all the contribution that they made to the Country Squires over the years. Alan Sparks, did I mention him? No, Alan Sparks died in 94. He's the sixth one that's passed on. He played guitar for us for many, many years. And he has a daughter that's doing real good and following his footsteps. And also, did I mention that my son, Gene Akery, is on the drums up there? He's been with us for a long time. He tried his hand down in Nashville, down in the Tampa Bay area for about a year and a half with the Greg Allman Band. He worked the Bay Area on the cruise ships, but they just smoked too much for him. He's not a smoker. He never did smoke, and he just couldn't stand all that smoke. So him and Debbie and come back home, and then they got me a granddaughter after 15 years. So I'm so glad they didn't stay down there. Right now, yes, we have. We've got a request for you to do a song. It's a recitation, okay. He wants to do a real pretty thing. I'm going to let him tell you what it is.
Well, every time I get around where there's a bunch of people, my friend Angie out there always wants me to do this thing. Archie Campbell used to do it on Hee Haw all the time, so if you bear with me about 2 or 3 minutes, it's called a spoonerism, and it's a story about Rendersella. Once upon a time in a corn country, there lived a beautiful burl, and her name was Rendersella. Also in this corn country, there lived a prancing hens. And he decided to have a fancy fall and invite all the beautiful young burros around Sutter Kite to attend this fancy fall. Rendersella's old mother, the other, jumped up and down with joy. She said, "My two beautiful daughters will go, but not you, Rendersella. You'll stay home." So Rendersella just cat down and shrine because she didn't have anything to wear except some old dirty dags. And while she was a kitten there shrine, there suddenly appeared before her a merry fodgather. And he waved his magic wand, and Rendersella's old dirty dags turned into a beautiful bound. He said, "Rendersella, you go to the Bancy Fall, have yourself a good time, but be home by the time the clock strikes midnight, or your period will turn into a chunkin'." Rendersella went to the Bancy Fall, and she danced all night with the prancing hens, and she didn't watch what time it was. Suddenly the clock did strike midnight, and Rendersella straced down her rares and slopped her gripper. This prancing hens took this last gripper and searched all over the Sutter Kite, trying to find a beautiful girl whose foot it fit. He tried on Rendersella's mugly other, and it fit and did. He tried it on her two sad blisters, and it fit and did. And he tried it on Rendersella, and it fit and did. So the moral of the story is, if you want to marry a prancing hens and loll and fub and live happily the rest of your life, you go to a Bancy Fall and slop your dripper.
Thank you. I wonder if we could get all the entertainers that were here to come on up, and maybe we could talk you guys into doing a gospel number with all of us. Well, oh yeah, you go right ahead. A nice round of applause for Andy Akery and the Country Squires.
Kenny and Don and the rest of the folks. We're going to all spread around, get close to the microphone. Which one are we going to do, Kenny? We're going to do I Saw the Light, I believe. So if y'all want to join in and sing along with us, we'd appreciate it. We want to say thanks to all of you for coming out. And a nice round of applause again for our two new inductees, Dolph Hewitt, Andy Acree, and the Country Squires. We really appreciate them. Great pioneers in country music in the state of Illinois. We're all going to sing a little I Saw the Light. Is that right, Kenny? Here we go.
Entertainment. We want to thank all the entertainers for helping us with this tribute. Now, ladies and gentlemen, it gives me great pleasure to introduce a show created from the traditions of the barn dance shows and formulated to preserve and continue those traditions. Please make welcome, with the traditional ringing of the cowbell.
Sorry.
The Illinois Barn Dance, and here is Shauna and the Country Cloggers.
Thank you. Thank you all very much. I want to take just a quick second here to make a couple of announcements. We are the Illinois Barn Dance, and this is the Illinois Barn Dance Dinner Theater, and you're all welcome to come and see us anytime that you have an opportunity. Our next Saturday night performance here is November 8th, and then on November 16th, we have Ken Bradbury and his group of players from the Jacksonville Triopia area with a thing called the Coon Ridge Folk Festival. And then, of course, November 22nd, we have our Thanksgiving show, and December 13th, we have our Christmas show, so you're welcome to come and see us. We have dinner with each of our shows, and we have a good time. We've got a few extra folks up here. I'm going to introduce the band in just a little while, but right now, we're going to go back and do a Patsy Cline song for you. This is Frida with I Fall to Pieces. Across the stage here from Jacksonville, Illinois, on the piano, Miss Marcia Nelson. And you know, I said our guitar player couldn't make it because of car trouble, and called a while ago, and I announced that we needed one, and all of a sudden we had two. So that just tells you how nice all the country music folks are. Just takes you a long time to get up here. Okay. This is Mr. Ken Cooley, who was with the Arkansas Travelers for many years, and of course they're members of our Hall of Fame. Ken, we appreciate it. And this fella came all the way, what was it, North Carolina? Charleston, South Carolina, okay. Oh, long way. I don't know if we had anybody, we did have somebody from New York or something one time. I don't know which one's further, but we're glad to have him with us, Mr. Jack Sampson. The young lady who sang for you earlier and sings some harmony with us and everything, Miss Lanice Kirk from Root House, Illinois. On rhythm and vocals back here with a pretty blue guitar, that's Frida Hirsch from Bushnell, Illinois.
from Jacksonville. A good buddy of ours, been playing bass there for many years, and we've enjoyed playing music with him for I don't know how many times we've played music together, and we're really happy that he's part of our show. Mr. Rob Killen. And on the other pretty blue guitar from Virginia, Illinois, Polly Farmer.
Yeah, Polly!
And back on those drums back there, from Jacksonville, Illinois, Mr. Marty Buck. Yeah. And Charlie said save the prettiest till last, so.
Yeah, thank you.
Something's wrong with this mic cord here, I think. Anyway. I just mentioned Charlie's name and everything just quits. Did you notice that? From all the way down around Carrollton, Illinois, plays steel guitar and sings some pretty songs for us. This little George Strait song, Mr. Charlie Withrow. Yeah. We'll get Frieda back out here for you and do a song. This is a song written by Roger Miller and recorded years later by Highway 101. It's called Walking, Talking, and Crying.
I'm the one.
Now I'd like to welcome Shauna back on the stage with the Tanya Tucker song.
Delta Dawn, what's that flower you have on? Could it be a faded rose from days gone by? And did I hear you say he was a meeting here today to take you to his mansion in the sky? She's 41 and her daddy still calls her baby. All the folks round Brownville say she's crazy. Cause she walks downtown with a suitcase in her hand, looking for a mysterious dark-haired man. In her younger days, they call her Delta Dawn. Greatest woman you ever laid eyes on. Then a man of blood and grief stood by her side.
Folks with us on our show as regulars. Sean is one of them. Another one is Mr. Phil Merritt.
I do a little more Haggard for you right now. Thank you.
Phil. We just love to hear this young lady sing these type of songs, and we're going to let her do this for you right now. It's called Phones Are Ringing. Here's Lenice Kirk. We could get our cloggers to come out here and dance for you before we move on with the rest of the show. We're going to do a John Michael Montgomery song for you that they dance to, and Mr. Phil here sings it for you. It's called Soul.
I'm not going to be a ship, but she just called.
you've enjoyed our portion of the show. Don't go away, we're not ready to take an intermission, but we're ready to move on to some different things here. On behalf of all of us, we'd like to thank Patsy Montana, Merle Haggard, Patsy Cline, Jim Reeves, and the many others who performed the songs that we sang for you today. We'd like to also thank the barn dances of the past and present who have paved the way for all of us. We'd like to thank the new artists that we borrowed songs from today, like Martina McBride or John Michael Montgomery, and the many others who continue to promote the music we love to perform. We'd like to thank the fans who have been loyal to the music since WLS first broadcast in 1924. But most of all, we'd like to thank God. And so to close our part of this tribute and celebration of the art form that we call country music, here's Marcia and the Barn Dance Singers with this Red Foley classic, Peace in the Valley.
Mentioned the WLS Barn Dance, who started it all in 1924, launching the careers of many national and international stars. There have been many barn dances through the years, the WSM Barn Dance, later called the Grand Ole Opry, and the Renfro Valley Barn Dance in Kentucky, both still running regular shows. When the WLS Barn Dance closed its doors, one of its stars, Dolph Hewitt, originally from Snuff Holler, Pennsylvania, took 18 of his associates over to WGN Radio and began the WGN Barn Dance. Dolph had been enjoying a successful recording career and working for the WLS Barn Dance, but it was clear the changes were coming. So he talked to WGN and convinced them to continue the Barn Dance radio on their station. Well, the radio show proved to be an instant hit with its regular cast of Dolph Hewitt, Red Blanchard, Bob Adger, the Johnston sisters, the Sage Riders, Bob and Bobby Thomas, Cousin Tilford, and Archie the Arkansas Woodchopper. Dolph Hewitt served as the show's producer and was responsible for continuing the popularity of his cast. The show toured across the Midwest, and then WGN and Dolph launched the WGN Barn Dance TV show, and in 1965, the show won an Emmy for Family Entertainment from the National Academy of Television and the Arts. The comedy for the show was supplied by MC Donald Red Blanchard, who believed that good old country humor appeals to everybody, and by 6 foot, 10-inch Cousin Tilford. The music was provided by the Sage Riders, Tiny Murphy, Toby Nix, Lionel Frigo, Johnny Frigo, and Jimmy Hutchinson. Regular cast members were joined by other top-name acts for guest spots such as Loretta Lynn, George Hamilton IV, Johnny Cash, and Rex Allen. The show was made up of family and friends, and were welcomed into the hearts and the homes of family and friends known to all of us as fans. So from the 1960s to the 1970s, Dolph Hewitt and the WGN Barn Dance, over on 720 on the radio dial and on Channel 9 on TV, were pioneers who continued the tradition set forth by WLS Barn Dance and gave it a modern 60s look and appeal, keeping country music popular on the radio and television in Chicago and in the Midwest. Dolph began his career as a fiddle player, later learning guitar and singing his way into the hearts of many fans. He first appeared on radio in 1933 for WWVA in Wheeling, West Virginia, then moving to KMOX in St. Louis and the Pappy Cheshire programs of the CBS network, where he would sing with the pop music shows as Eddie. As a Marine, Dolph was a communications specialist going ashore at Iwo Jima and later serving as a tank division in the tank division. Then Dolph joined Special Services, where he would entertain. Dolph recorded over 200 special radio programs for the armed forces. When he was released from military service, he was discharged at the Great Lakes Naval Base, just a stone's throw away from WLS Barn Dance, and it wasn't long before he was making history at WLS. Then as things changed at WLS, Dolph and Company moved to WGN, where the TV program was syndicated into 120 cities. During Dolph's recording career, he recorded The Little Folks for Cap Records.
Breakdown was the theme song of the WGN Barn Dance, the song that he wrote. WGN Barn Dance recorded many records, including the Cap album, which we have on display over here, called Saturday Night at the Old Barn Dance.
America's oldest and best loved country and western show, the one and only original Barn Dance. Well, friends, it's always a treat to listen to one of those wonderful songs from the boy with the voice like a friendly handshake, the king of the Barn Dance, Dolph Hewitt.
Dolph was an accomplished songwriter, penning several songs, including Someone Hurt You, and the popular You Gave Me Back My Ring, Now Please Give Me Back My Heart. What we're listening to now is his recording of Little Folks.
We've agreed to disagree and go our We just don't seem to get along. We argue and we fight. So we've agreed that the hardest friend is what's for both of us. But what's gonna happen to the little folks? The little folks.
As Rich mentioned, Dolph Hewitt started out as a fiddle player. And we're going to listen to a song that he recorded live with some members of the Barn Dance called The Mockingbird. Here's a little bit of that. Johnson of the popular Barn Dance singing Johnson Sisters. And over the years, millions of fans have heard Dolph Hewitt, known to most of them as the King of the Barn Dance. Now, Dolph died recently at his home in Central Florida with his family at his side. I had the pleasure many times to talk to Dolph over the phone, and I really enjoyed our conversations and his influence in starting the Barn Dance here, and the Country Music Hall of Fame was great. And I appreciated my conversations with him very much. Introduced many times by Red Blanchard as the man with the friendly voice, which seems to reach out and shake hands with you, the King of the Barn Dance, Dolph Hewitt. It is with great pleasure that we induct Dolph Hewitt and the WGN Barn Dance into the Country Music Hall of Fame, and we accept on behalf of Ruth and her family and the members of the crew and cast this certificate of induction, thanking everyone on their behalf. And now, ladies and gentlemen, we're going to close out the first half of our show with our dancers and a little piano tune called Down Yonder. We'll take a brief intermission, and don't go away. We'll be right back. good friends of most of you out there, and I know a lot of you were shaking hands with them and haven't seen them for a long, long time. Just like Andy and his group, these two fellows were part of a group that played with Uncle Johnny Barton on WHOW and over in Decatur on television with the Corn Belt Country shows that Uncle Johnny had. Ben and Ken have been really good friends of the museum, done a lot of work for us. Every year we have a fan festival down in Hillsboro, Illinois, and every year Ben and Ken are there with us and doing work, selling tickets, performing on stage, and helping us out a lot. And that has greatly helped our museum here, because the museum is totally separate from the barn dance. The museum is a non-profit organization, and the only funds that the museum has are funds of that we generate through Hillsboro and our fan festival and to our induction ceremony today. And that's really the only funds that the museum has. The rest of it, we get donations here now and again from folks. And some of the folks who have given us donations, cash donations to buy things with and things, are right here. And of course, then we get a lot of donations of things. If you go through the museum, you see Patsy Montana's, some of her outfits that she sang with on stage. Al Harvey from the Possum Holler Opry, some of his things are in there. And but these two fellows have done an awful lot of work, and Ben and a whole crew of folks from the Illinois Country Music Association came down one day and helped us nail up some of this wood that you see around here and hang up curtains and things like that, and we really appreciate it. So we'd like for you to give a nice round of applause, get them out here and do a couple of numbers for you. Here's Ben and Ken Cooley from the Arkansas Travelers.
Thank you very much. It's wonderful to be here, and I think we ought to thank Dennis and Holly and their family. This is a great effort they got going here to try to serve the community. And Dennis, it's my pleasure to help you whenever I can, because, you know, we got country music today, but we've had it for a long time. We'd like to keep the old traditional country around as long as we can. So I'd like to do one for you. The first song, I'm just going to do a couple, and then we got a lot of folks here. First one I'm going to do for you is one that Ray Price put out some years ago. One's titled Walk Me to the Door. Thank you. You know, it's a pleasure being here this afternoon. Of course, at my and Kenny's age, it's a pleasure to be anywhere. And I've noticed that the hair don't grow as fast on the top of the head as it used to, but it sure grows out your ears faster.
Secretary of the Illinois Country Music Association and our good friend Don Suter.
And I think we're going to have a special guitar guest up here with us. Here he comes. Mr. Alan Harris is going to pick with us on this one. Hey, Alan.
Oh, thank you so much.
I just kind of left you to get dressed by yourself there, didn't I?
Shelton song.